Alright. Hello everyone and welcome back to Late Night Beats. In this week's episode, I'd like to give you my first impression on the Soma Laboratory's Lyra 8, which is an amazing instrument. Let's get right into it. As you might see, I'm in my new space here. I recently changed apartments. It took me some time to set everything up in this new space, but I'm very happy with how it all works out. And generally, I'm ready to get back to recording. I was lucky enough to get the Lyra 8 synthesizer in the studio for a couple of days, and I have to tell you right now that I'm very surprised by this synthesizer. Of course, I'm aware of this instrument from all the demos and the overall hype that it generated within the community. People were really praising it for being something new, something completely groundbreaking, and something fresh in this kind of stale analog synthesizer space. At first, I was not really impressed, mostly because it didn't have MIDI, and I'm a bit of a control freak. I like my synthesizers to listen to me. Lyra is not listening to anyone. You have to listen to it. And it's kind of refreshing, to be honest. And then a very good friend of mine brought it to the studio last Sunday just to check it out, just to jam a little bit and enjoy the synthesizer. And I was like, sure, I'd love to check it out. Not only that, he was kind enough to leave it with me for a couple of days to experiment and maybe record this short first impressions video. What are my first impressions on that? Well, first of all, I think it's really pretty. Let me explain why I think this is important, especially for people who are not professional artists, who, like me, just play music from time to time, just have fun with it. It is important for an instrument to be appealing and exciting. My studio is usually in the corner of my living room, so when I walk in there, I need to feel excited. I need to see it and I need to want to play it. And some examples of beautiful instruments that are inspiring just by the way they look is my Ibanez Artist, for example. Machine Mark III is very pretty. Mono Machine also is exciting, makes you want to play it. And Lyra, in my opinion, is similar. Some people call it a pizza box with knobs. It's brutalistic, but also very interesting and kind of appealing in this sort of primitive way. I like it. So Lyra is an 8-voice analog synthesizer with each voice having a fixed pitch that you can set with the knobs in here. And when it comes to the sounds, the oscillators are really rich. They're not quantized at all, so you need to find that pitch. You need to have good ears to operate that in a sort of musically meaningful way. But the oscillators are really something. Something special. What's more, as you probably know, I really love saturating my synthesizers, and the saturator on the Lyra is really powerful. Let's hear it. Similar to the distortion we get from the Strymon Deco. Let's compare it. Of course, the built-in saturation is more in line with the oscillators, but Deco sounds kind of interesting. And Strymon Deco is one of my favorite effects of all time. And I'm using it extensively on the Lyra to give it even more unpredictability. Let's hear it. So what I'm doing with the Deco, I have it set up to blend so that the second deck is only functional. The lag time is at zero in here so that there's no delay in here. And then the wobble is at max, which gives it this sort of weird and moving quality, which I really, really like. I'm actually going to keep the saturator and the lag section on for this demo. I did not expect to like how the synthesizer is being controlled with those strange touchpads where you need to close the circuit for them to play. But they're really kind of expressive and nice, I like that. And of course, you can use coins to trigger them permanently. sound is interesting in its own right. You can just leave it on and it's going to create this interesting drone that can really fill out your mix and give it a little bit more interest and life. So one way you can generate drones is of course use the coin. But the second option you have is using the hold function. And with this functionality, you can use the sharp knob in here to control how much of each oscillator you want in your mix. Let's check it. And then you can use the fast function here to switch it off. Of course, there's always a risk of bumping into the tune knob and messing up your patch, which I just did, but that's the beauty of the synthesizer. So where the real magic happens is in the cross mod. Let's take a look at the first four oscillators in here. That was pretty wild. And then the next thing you can do is to use the LFO. I haven't yet looked at any more functionalities really. I sort of understand the characteristic more or less, but I haven't looked at the manual. I haven't really looked at a lot of demos. I'm just sort of playing around with it. And I think that's exactly how the synthesizer is meant to be used, to be perfectly honest with you. To me, it has the richness and unpredictability of a modular system, but without the modular stigma, by which I mean no bleeps and blobs and no idiosyncrasies typically connected with the modular system. Without a shadow of a doubt, this synthesizer wants to draw you in and wants you to spend time with it. And it's actually, every time you do that, it's kind of unpredictable, it's always a journey, and it's always a lot of fun. The question is, of course, how much mileage can you get out of those sounds and with those controls that you have in here? So it really depends on the type of music that you're making. If you're an ambient or a drone or a noise artist, I think it's a must-have for you. You need to have it because it's just so organic and it's going to add so much richness into your music making process. All right, so that's it for this episode of Late Night Beats. Let me know in the comments what your thoughts are on the Lyra 8 and if you had the chance to check it out yourself. Also let me know if you'd like me to do an in-depth exploration of the Lyra 8. I might have it in the studio for a bit longer, so there might be an opportunity for me to do that. As always, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you're new to this channel, consider subscribing to catch more tutorials, more jams, and more opinions. And also follow me on Instagram at Late Night Beats to get more updates from the studio. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great night. Take care.